Hello everyone, time for a new game. Now this might be a bit of a change because this is not what I usually do. This is not a Spelunky game or anything of those sorts. This is a bit more of an interesting kind of game, let's say. So if you're wondering exactly what's going on, you'll see fairly quickly. So let's start a match. This is Forge of Magic the Gathering. I'm not going to go into too much detail about what this is, but Magic the Gathering is a trading card game very popular in the US. Many people know about this, and this basically is a computer game that implements that specific trading card game with all its rules, so that you can play against the AI opponents. So this is what I'll be playing. I will try to explain some of the rules bit by bit. Basically, right now it's my first turn, and I'm the one starting the game. This is my hand. So let's first summon Desert of the Fervent, which is a land card, play land. This one gets added tapped already because that's what the rule of the game. As you can see in the rule on the card, Desert of the Fervent enters the battlefield tapped, so it's already tapped right now. Then I'm going to end my turn since there's nothing else I can do at this point. End turn. Now it's my opponent's turn. He plays his own land, which is a mountain. Press OK. And now it's my turn again. Good. So let's get straight to it. I'll play a mountain card. So right now I've got two red lands. One of them is the Desert of the Fervent. The other is a mountain. Not much to say. Nothing else I can do. End turn. My opponent plays another mountain. And then he taps both mountains to generate mana. And now he has Path, and with their mana he summoned Pathmaker Initiate, which is a 2/1 card, 2/1 creature with the ability that when it gets tapped, my opponent can target a creature, and that target creature with power 2 or less cannot be blocked that turn. Okay, so he can make any creature with power 2 or less be unblockable. That's annoying. So now it's our turn. I'm putting down some more red mana, and now I'm going to summon Minotaur Sure Shot. The reason I didn't do that before is because I didn't have enough mana before. As you can see on the top right description of the card, you need 1 red mana and 2 other mana of any color to summon this card. So I needed in total 3 mana, and right now I have the 3 mana, which is from Desert of the Fervent and these 2 mountains. So right now I have 3 mana, enough to summon this guy. So let's play. And now we've got Minotaur Sure Shot, which is a 2/3 creature, which has reach and also another ability. So let's end. And now he summoned Stormblood Berserker, which is annoying. He's got Blood Force 2, which means that if an opponent was dealt damage this turn, this creature enters the battlefield with 2+1/+1 counters on it. And he also has Menace, which is the most annoying thing, which means that this creature cannot be blocked except by 2 or more creatures. So I've got another land right now. I drew another land card this turn, which is a Plains card. Might as well use that, but sadly I cannot summon any of these creatures because they are black creatures, and they, as you can see at the top right of each of them, they require black mana, and I have no black mana at this point. So there's nothing much more I can do. Let's end the turn. It's my opponent's turn. He uses Stormblood Berserker to attack me, and because I've only got Minotaur Sure Shot, I cannot block him because Stormblood Berserker has Menace. So that means I need at least 2 monsters to block him. And since I've only got Minotaur Sure Shot, I cannot block him. So let's go through this. I took damage. From 15 health I went to 14, which is the number equal to the attack power that Stormblood Berserker has. And finally I got a black mana. It's a swamp. Let's put this down. And with this black mana we can now summon any of these black cards. Well, most of them. Torment of Venom requires 2 black mana, so and 2 other mana of any color. So since I've got only 1 black mana, I cannot summon that. So let's go with Wasteland Scorpion. I'm going to summon him. And I think now we're ready. I'm not going to attack him with any of my creatures because I want these creatures to be untapped so I can block him the next turn if he would decide to attack me with Stormblood, a Berserker again. What the fuck did he just do? He used Chandra's Outrage. Chandra's Outrage deals 4 damage to target creature and 2 damage to that creature's controller. Oh, that's nasty. So my Scorpion is dead from that spell card, from that instant, I guess I should say. And now he attacks me with Stormblood Berserker, and since I've only got 1 creature again, I cannot block him. That sucks. Next. So, can I summon Inferno Titan? It will require 2 red mana and 4 other mana. So 2 I've already got, and I've only got 3 others, so I cannot summon him. I don't have enough mana. I can summon Lurching Rod Beast or Carrion Screecher. Hard to say what I want. Let's go with Lurching Rod Beast. As you can see, I've got between the options of summoning it, which would cost me the full total mana cost that it would normally cost me, or I can cycle it for just 1 black mana, so that I discard, and draw a different one from my deck. Well, now I'm going to summon it. Awuto. Let's go, end turn. So it's my opponent's turn again. He attacks me with Stormblood Berserker. This time I can block him because I've finally got 2 creatures. So I can deal with his a menace ability. So let's block him with... I don't think the order counts, so let's just block him with both of these. Wait, why can't I block? Ah, he used... Okay, so he tapped Pathmaker Initiate to make Berserker, Stormblood Berserker, unblockable. Right. So now I cannot block him even if I wanted to, which is extremely annoying. Oh, this sucks. Let's do Painful Lesson. And I will target myself. So Painful Lesson is a sorcery card. When I cast it, the target player will draw 2 cards and will lose 2 life at the same time. I will use that on myself to draw more cards because right now I need them. And I got 2 swamps, which is exactly what I needed, so that I can use Torment of Venom. I need Torment of Venom as quickly as possible, so let's do that. Right now I don't have any more mana, so I'm ending my turn. He used Fiery Fall, which is an instant, and he dealt 5 damage to me, to one of my creatures. So that sucks. I've already got 3 creatures in my graveyard. Lurching Beast is dead now. Crap. He attacks me again. Okay, time to get serious since I'm really losing health. I've only got 7 health left, and if I reach 0 or below, it's game over for me. So let's put a swamp down. And finally, let's use Torment Venom on him. And with Torment Venom, what this does is that it's an instant, and when I activate it, I will be able to put 3 -1 counters on target creature. Its controller loses 3 life unless he or she sacrifices another non-land permanent or discards a card. So right now, I can put 3 -1/-1 counters on a target creature. So it's either Stormblood Berserker or Pathmaker Initiate in this case. Or my own creature, but I'm obviously not gonna do that, since that would kill it. Let's kill Pathmaker Initiate. So I selected that, pay the mana cost for that. And both of them died. The reason both of them died is that he chose to sacrifice the other creature as well to not lose his life points. So now he has no more creatures, and now I can finally attack him. So let's Alpha Strike with Minotaur Sure Shot. And I did 2 damage to him, which is not that much, but it's a start. Now he used Limits of Solidarity, which is a sorcery card, to gain control of my Minotaur Sure Shot. That's annoying. And he attacked me with my own card. Now I've got only 5 life left, which really sucks. So let's try to deal with that. I'm putting down another swamp card. And now I should have enough mana to summon Inferno Titan. Yeah, let's do that. And now when Inferno Titan gets summoned, like it says in the card description, whenever Inferno Titan enters the battlefield or attacks, it deals 3 damage divided as you choose among 1, 2, or 3 target creatures and or players. So since my opponent doesn't have any creature that I want to target, I'll just target himself as the player right now. So let's click on him. Okay. So he's gonna do 3 damage to him. He's got 18 life now. And now he's got 15 life. Now we can finally attack, so let's go to the attack stage. Alpha strike him. Inferno Titan cannot attack him just yet because I just summoned him this turn, so he's got summoning sickness. I have to wait another additional turn before he can attack, so I'll just attack with Minotaur Sure Shot. Okay, let's continue. He uses more mana, and now he uses that mana to summon Avatar of Fury and Obsidian Fire Heart. Oh, this looks strong. I don't want to deal with them. So, yeah, let's use the easy path out. Let's just use Torment of Venom. If I use Torment of Venom, I can either target Avatar of Fury or Obsidian Fireheart. And whichever one I choose will get 3 -1/-1 counters on them to weaken them. And the other one is gonna get sacrificed because the AI will want to sacrifice them to not lose life points. So I'm going to put the counters on Obsidian Fireheart, because that would really impair them. From my 4/4 power, they will get 1/1 because of the -1/-1 counters. The 3 -1/-1 counters I'll put on him, and then Avatar of Fury will be sacrificed. So let's do that. And yep, Avatar of Fury was sacrificed, so he's in the graveyard, and Obsidian Fireheart has been reduced to 1/1 power, so he's pretty much useless. Now with this ability, I still got 1 red, 1 white, and 1 black mana left to use on this turn. So what I can do is cast Without Weakness or summon Firebrand Archer. So let's summon Firebrand Archer. And now I'm kind of out of mana, so there's not much left I can do, so let's attack him now. Okay, let's Alpha Strike him. And press OK. And now since Inferno Titan is attacks, as the rule set on his card says, I might do 3 damage divided to however I want. So let's do 1 damage to Obsidian Fireheart and literally destroy him, since right now he's at 1/1 power. And then the remaining 2 damage will be done to the player, so Chandra, Pyromaster Field. Okay. Yeah, so let's distribute it. 1 I'm gonna do to the creature, and that should kill it, and the rest I'm gonna need to do the damage to Chandra directly. And now we're pretty much done. The field is cleared, and now we can do the actual damage from the creatures that we have. So Minotaur Sure Shot and Inferno Titan are going to do their damage. So 2 attack plus 6 attack is gonna be 8 attack. 11 minus 8 will mean that he's only gonna be left with 3 life left. And as you can see, that's right. So let's finish up. Whatever he's gonna do now, it should be pretty amazing because he's gonna lose the next turn. So he summons his own Inferno Titan card, which is quite surprising. And he did the 3 damage to me. So, yeah, I'm on the verge of dying, but it doesn't really matter because he's gonna die anyway. So let's put down our own Plains card. Let's summon Desert Cerodon. Summon it, not cycle it. We've got the Desert Cerodon on. We're ready to continue, baby. Good, so let's just Alpha Strike him. If I don't do this right now, he will probably attack me with Inferno Titan next turn, and he would do 3 damage to me to reduce my life from 2 to minus 1 and just kill me instantly. So I need to attack him right this turn before he can do that. Alpha Strike, okay. Let's do the 3 damage from my own Inferno Titan to him directly. And I won. Total game wins, win 250 games. Yeah, I've won an achievement. That's cool. And I got my own card as a victory. Tormenting Voice. It's a sorcery card for 1 red mana and 1 any other mana. As an additional cost to cast Tormenting Voice, discard a card and then draw 2 cards. That's not that impressive. Next game. Yeah, I'm not gonna mess around with the sideboard, that's an entirely different can of worms. I forgot to mention that this game is on a 2 out of 5 game basis. So whichever players wins 2 out of 5 games at least, wins the entire duel. Like, I just won once, so now I need to beat him again to definitively win. And even if I lose this game, I will have another game afterwards to play against him. Do you want to... So, Chandra Power Master is going first, I'm going second. Do you want to keep your hand? Yes. So let's go with this. Place down a swamp card as a land. And I get Grim Lavamancer in return. Okay. Let's put down a mountain card now. And now he is going to summon Chandra's Phoenix, which has flying and haste. Haste means that it can attack in the same turn that it's summoned, unlike creatures that don't have haste. So that sucks. And it's also got flying, so I cannot block it unless I also have a creature with flying or a creature with reach. That's annoying. So he's gonna attack me with both. No surprises there. And yeah, that really hurt me. Let's place down another swamp card, and now we've got enough mana to summon Kenra Scrapper. And turn. And he casts Searing Spear to deal 3 damage to my Kenra and killed it. That sucks. Okay, he's gonna attack me again. I'm at 9 life now, which is really dangerous. I don't wanna be in this situation. So let's get rid of his creatures. I'm gonna cast Torment of Venom again. And I'm gonna target Chandra's Phoenix to kill it instantly. And then he's also going to sacrifice Grim Lavamancer to not take life damage. Yeah, so I cleared the field. End turn, because I have no more mana left to spend. And no creatures on the battlefield to attack with. So he's going to summon Blood Ogre, which is a 2/2 Blood First One and First Strike creature. Really annoying. I don't like that. But I will be able to block it with Minotaur Sure Shot, so might as well do that. So we've got Minotaur Sure Shot doing its thing. And now he casts, I guess, Volcanic Geyser, which dealt some damage to my creature and literally destroyed it. And now he's going to attack me with Blood Ogre, which is annoying. Yeah, I can't afford any more bullcrap from him. Okay, so I've got 5 mana in total. What can I do? I don't have enough mana to summon Inferno Titan just yet. I don't have enough mana to summon Desert Cerodon just yet. I do have enough mana to summon Gilded Cerodon, although. So let's do that. And turn. Now he's summoning Battle Rattle Shaman, which is quite cool. At the beginning of combat on your turn, you may have target creature get +2/+0 until end of turn. That's extremely useful. So now he's attacking me with Blood Ogre. And I could block him with Gilded Cerodon. He's got 4 attack though, because probably due to Battle Rattle Shaman, it gave Blood Ogre +2 on top of the +2 attack it already had, so now it's +4. And now I can block that with Gilded Cerodon, but Gilded Cerodon has only 4 life. It's a 4/4 creature, which means that if it gets attacked by Blood Ogre, it will die. Especially since Blood Ogre has first strike. The first strike in it means that it will be able to destroy Gilded Cerodon before Gilded Cerodon can kill it. So it's going to destroy. So basically at the end of the combat, if I block Blood Ogre of Gilded Cerodon, will just remain intact. Or it will be completely destroyed, is what I mean. So Blood Ogre will survive and Gilded Cerodon will die. That's bad. So what we're going to do instead is let that attack pass through. I'm going to go down from 7 life to 3 life. But I'm going to cast Torment of Venom right now and kill both of these. And now it should be fine. Now I can attack him with Gilded Cerodon with an Alpha Strike. And now I'm finally starting to do damage to him. I kind of cleared out his board. He doesn't have that many creatures left. He's only got Pathmaker Initiate left at this point, which isn't that great for him. So let's put down planes, the planes card, and now we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 lands in total. That's enough to summon Inferno Titan. So let's do that. And now I can do the free distributed damage however I want. One of it I'm going to apply on Pathmaker, on his Pathmaker Initiate to destroy it. And the other 2 remaining damage I'm going to do on him directly. So, okay. Yes. Okay. And now I can just Alpha Strike his ass. Okay, so he didn't do anything this turn. I'm guessing he's out of good cards in his hand. I cannot see his hand, I believe. Or I can I see his hand? I don't think I should be able to see his hand. I don't know what that is. Whatever. So let's just I can summon another creature, or I can cast an Ward Victory to double the damage that Inferno Titan is doing. Yeah, just like that. And now I'm just going to attack him. I can attack with both of them or just with Inferno Titan. It doesn't matter since his health will be depleted to 0 either way. So let's just attack him with Inferno Titan. I'm going to do 12 damage to him. Since Inferno Titan is attacking, I need to choose how the free damage he gets distributed. I'm going to apply their damage to my opponent directly. So from 10 life he will go to 7 life, and now Infernal Titan will actually attack him with 12 attack. So he's only got 7 life, he won't be able to absorb it, he will lose. And he's got minus 5 life now, so I won the entire match. Now I get to choose a card that I will get from a bonus booster set as my reward. So I can either get my card from the Hour of Devastation booster set or from the Amonkhet booster set, whichever one I choose. Let's go with the Amonkhet one. So I got these three cards, I believe. I got Brute Strength, which is an instant card, and basically target creature gets +3/+1 and gains trample until the end of turn. That's really good. Nimble Obstructionist, which is a creature card, a bird wizard card that has flash and flying, and for 2 mana and 1 blue mana I can cycle it when it's in my hand to discard it and draw a different card instead. And finally, Temet Vizier of Naktamun, which is a legendary creature that's really nice, probably super rare, for which I can do Embalm for 3 mana, 1 green, one light mana and 1 blue mana. But I can also, at the beginning of combat on your turn, target creature token you control gets +1/+1 until the end of turn and cannot be blocked this turn. So really fucking nice. Good. So that's it for today's episode. Thank you for watching.